Oh my gosh, man. Actually, shameless. This is just insane.
Now, we begin.
Hey, what's up, YouTube? It's Journey Realms back with some more Yorick gameplay. We're popping the top lane. If you like the video, subscribe to the channel. Should be a great game. I think I'll hopefully help you a little bit with the Poppy Yorick matchup. And then I think their team comp's pretty good for me, looking like it with the my ability to split push and maybe create macro game pressure. So hopefully that's the win con I can really play to. Poppy early on, the Qs can definitely do a lot of damage, so you want to avoid getting poked by them. You see she's like using them the last hit. In the meantime, I'm just building up ghouls early on. Poppy has this little buckler. If you step on it, if she picks it up, it'll give her a shield. If you step on it, it'll kill it. Now you want to be careful because sometimes you can kind of get baited next to a wall and get a wall slammed. Now I believe we played versus Poppy once already, and I haven't played this match too much, but I know her E interacts with the wall is kind of clunky. Maybe I can just like test it out this game, see how it really works. I think people were saying, I was reading some of the comments, but I forget what people were saying. I think people were saying that it doesn't really slam you into it, which would be good. Not a good E. I need to focus. That's a bad E anyways, because I need to.
It's you,
the bad E anyways, because. Oh, really? And he's their E's more when she's like going for CS. It's usually a better time. I think when I played versus Alawi, that's one of the things I failed at was throwing E at times when Poppy was stuck in some or Alawi was stuck in some sort of animation. Look at there. I think that's kind of how it works. Cool. Her W does block my ghouls from leaping onto her. So I expect to see her use it more as a way to high ghoul damage. It's like she just kind of pushes through the wall. Can't really tell for it. I'm not too worried about being flanked. I think Lily actually did back, and even if she didn't, I'm so bad. Even if she didn't, I think I could just ghost run away. Make sure to get the full slam. Ikram didn't get top scuttle, it's kind of interesting. Oh, this is a really good counter gank, though. Ooh, oh no! Fishing first. Get a little bit more gold for pickaxe. Could also go for ruby crystal longsword if I wanted to. Oh no. Oh, I controlled a little bit there. Going a little too hard. You see, I saved my teleport. Hopefully this cannon doesn't die. If the cannon doesn't die, I just lost three melee minions, 60 gold. About the same in experience, 80 gold in same in experience, but I get to save my teleport. So if I were in the shop right now and I could buy a teleport for 80 gold and some experience, would I do that? Yeah, I definitely would. My wall here to prevent some damage I take. You see here traps him. The one I'm holding for this, I can kind of chill out. Not really sure why Poppy would be set here. It's kind of weird. We need to clean this up a bit though. But, a lot of minions. Not very good. Gotta be careful when you're under turret. Do not be too close to the wall. Even here. She's using my wall and then the movement speed to kite out and minimize my damage. I probably ghosted way too late there. But so the real nice thing about ghosts is that if an enemy champion without... Oh wow, that's big. Curious? Might come back from it. Oh no! Something that kills me, right? No. Okay, cool. Nice. Okay, not bad. It sucked a lot of Lilia's time. You see, my jungler now has a level lead. Got to reset and get some tempo. Look at me, build Torch Holebreaker, even though I went to Jean first. And so you see, I mean, this matchup so far has just been about me. Whenever I landy, I get a lead, and I take a favorable trade. Anytime I miss you, I have to, like, kind of chill out. So I have to... So this lane would have gone better if I was just a little bit better about, like, throwing you at, like, really good times. Oh, rip. Kind of weird that she was walking up there. Oh, you're dead. All I have to do there is 100% sidestep that, and I win. That's all I have to do. So I just, you see me there, if, like, she was anticipating, I walk towards her because I would want to secure the kill. But I don't want to secure the kill, because as long as I dodge, like, the only way I lose here is I get ulted away. So instead of trying to go for damage output, I'm just patient. And I make sure I walk in a really perpendicular way from where I think she'll want to throw it. And that just optimizes my chance of dodging it. And once I dodge it, it's GG. A lot of players will get really impatient when they see players get really close to dying. And they won't think about the fact that there's really no rush. I'm gonna back off. I don't want Maiden to take turret aggro.
How quick the turn from blessed to cursed.
I'm just gonna reset for momentum. The other play I can do right now is see if the scuttle's up and then go take that. And then go back to top because I'm pretty healthy and I don't, you know, I'm pretty healthy, I have good mana. Like, I don't have to reset. But then it's kind of awkward because then for the next few minutes, I'm gonna be sitting on 1300 gold with a gold that I could have in stats that could lead to another kill or this turret or winning a 1v2, and maybe there's not a good opportunity for me to recall again in the next few minutes. So I'd rather take the momentum of being able to back there and come back to like a pretty good state of wave with the cannon and all that. Again, people a lot of times will prioritize gold instead of momentum, but there is value in momentum. Momentum can lead to more gold. My curse is our only. I have Ghost. I feel okay. They have good CC chains if Lilia has R. Use the wall just to be like, hey, Poppy, back off. Run down the river. Oh, Lilia's down there. I wonder if Scuttle is up. A lot of people would try to be like, hey, take Rift. And if Hecarim wants to, it's fine. If Hecarim clears topside jungle. I think it's actually better to take topside jungle on their side and I just do what I'm about to do. Fine. Can't heal off the wave. Puppy should probably reset. If she doesn't, I can probably get a kill off her under turret if I just land 1E. Or I get turret. Didn't demolish in Sheen. You see here, my jungle cleared his topside, and then he's taking the rift. And if I want to run down and help, I can. But my reason for not taking rift was I had enough other things to do that were better that led to like just more gold outcome. Like gold per minute outcome. Lilia down there. I'm gonna go and take these if they're up, and they're not. That's okay. I'll go reset. I'll get a Holebreaker and start building toward my Trinity Force. I might just want to get an early Merc Treads too. They really good suit. Let's go and get that. It's real valuable. Unfortunate timing on the Krugs spawning then. One thing you've noticed is every time I've backed, I've been able to back off a pushed in wave. So every time I'm walking back to wave, I'm back to a wave safe that's like pushed into me, and I've only lost a minimal amount of minions per reset. What we're going for, right? If you're going to reset, you want to do it while losing the minimum amount you can. That's really key to keeping like high CS numbers. Though right now I'm not quite at 10 CS per minute, but it doesn't take much to get back in there. Take a couple Krugs, maybe take topside jungle a few times. Free flash. Missed the. I made it just absolutely destroying this Poppy. Oh, see there, I tried to dodge again. Alright, cool. I wasn't sure where Lily was actually. I didn't see her bot side, even though I had vision.
It is to the grave we go.
Wait for the next wave. He goes off the wave.
What's one more grave?
The wall knockup got me aggro. Like Lily might be here soon. I just saw Nivea mid, still, just what I want to see. Off the ghost, so I would take the minimum amount of damage possible from like turrets. I could like bounce in and out and just make sure I get the kill. I don't know where Nivea is, which is the whole reason I'm not going for Fred right now. Happened there. It should be in here. Bait this. Okay. Alright. Alright, bud. No! I think I bit off a little bit more than I could chew, me and Ezreal there. That's okay. I would have killed a Nivea very early if I had actually bought Trinity Force. That would have made a big difference. But just not having Trinity Force there. Maybe going for that without Trinity Force just isn't the play. Just back, reset, spend gold. His turns this. I want to teleport, but also top wave looks really juicy, and I don't have to teleport for it. I don't have Maiden. Holdbreaker's not good in like the group up fight. Ekrem could just farm his own side of the jungle. Seems like the better play is just to not teleport. Specifically, this is a large amount of gold. Actually, I think I want to deny one more wave. So what I'm going to do is just keep letting this push in. And because there's so many minions here, it's just going to obliterate this wave. And it's just going to deny the enemy team one more wave. It should deny more from the enemy than it... In theory. Oh, well. All right. At least he didn't get it. Lily has been a big problem.
Soon.
Hello? Sorry, I was watching the minimap and Hecarim has Yumi. So I was like, where are y'all? Oh my gosh, dude. There's so much move speed. This is nuts. My ghost just came up. Oh, there are a lot of people thinking that Holebreaker works with Yumi on you, but... Where'd Yumi go? I keep looking at my buffs when Yumi's on me, and I don't see Holebreaker. So I think they fixed that. Really good wall. We should ghost there.
We are dead much longer than we
are. If I had to guess, it's I did my maiden. I think Manage is dead. Yeah, this Lily is really, really obnoxious. Watching the minimap a lot. Oh my gosh, man. Actually, shameless. Wow! This is just insane. Okay. That's fine. She is obsessed with me, it turns out. Grudge should help a lot. I'll just get Grudge. I'll chill out, get Grudge. It's fine. Which one? Yeah. I'm gonna summon Maiden, maybe go top. I should be free kill, right? Big. Go Fizz. Good job. Kind of lucky on Fizz's part that the Poppy tried to ult during the Fizz knockup. Oh! Oh, please don't die here. I'm just gonna go to Drake. There's no time to go top to split. So I just summoned Maiden and get the fight. I definitely want this Drake. You will. What hell is worse than this limbo? Oh, that E doesn't hit anyone. Curious. Oh, nice. Saved. Oh. You mess up. Mess up so badly. Big. Yeah, fighting around their team is just incredibly annoying. Oh, what the heck? Ow. Oh, okay. Yeah, I don't know. We had three people alive. I didn't think a Nivy would just be able to, like, walk through here. My bad. Oh, no! No! Okay, okay. I think E's back up. E's out. Yep, good. Stay with? Yep, nice. Good job. Dang, their team fight's so hard to deal with. I need to split way more than I am. The problem is that I keep splitting and then they just, Jenna and Lilia just keep running at me. Makes it real difficult. I should go cover bot. I've got 3 minutes to make a lot of fuss in the bot lane. I'm assuming they're just hovering. Their shot this whole time has just been to us over me. Dude. I hate this Janna so much. I hate this Janna. Is there anything teleport to? No. Dang. Team's doing well though. They recognized what the enemy team was doing pretty early on. It was like, I heard a lot of pings of them trying to make plays elsewhere on the map. But I knew they were like trying to make something happen. I knew they weren't. So the worst thing that teams will do is they'll like kind of AFK and watch you. Like, no, you don't need to watch what I'm doing. And you see why I love Grudge so much. Grudge kept me alive in the last fight. It let me get away with between that and Ghost. If I land on Lucian ever, he's dead. Same with Anivia. Works doesn't work quite as well as Lily and Lulu or Janna. They have a million move speed. How much damage I do. Opportunity to get a couple of nibs. Cool. Ezreal has enough movement capability, especially with Yumi on him, that I don't need to like hang out there. Let him finish up. They might have a ward here and they might try to punish us. Probably not. I really need mana. Cool. This is absolutely a game for Force of Nature. Even a monk needs bread and water. Breaks up in 40. But a brief disinterment. We have two inhibs up. We should probably just give Drake Force Baron and then go top would be correct. Probably the best play we could do right now. Like maybe I should just go. I could go Force Baron. Has become skin. Or you just push. Right in the end. Hopefully they just take a while. Because the teams are very poke heavy, I'm hoping that this works. Nice! Oh, that's cathartic. Bye bye. Nice job. I just get that in the game. Super good. Yeah, I wish I had been able to split a little bit more. The problem was they just kept obsessing over me. It made it really hard because Janna and Lilia have so much like ability to slow me and speed themselves up and made it really hard. But once we had Grudge, we were able to kite him out and kind of split him up, which is really effective. Super happy with how I played overall that game. Really good. Six, good win, loss so far, really happy with that. Top damage, super good. Top damage to turrets, of course, it's not even close. Lilia is really mad. I'm fine with that. They were very, very focused. We had a pretty good gold lead throughout the entire game. I was able to generate a significant gold lead when I took turret. And I don't even think I had that many kills at this point, right? I have one kill. I had two kills. But still, at 13 minutes, two kills is only, 600 gold. So the rest of the 2,700 gold lead is basically purely from wave bouncing mechanics. And I guess kind of from the kills, because I would get plates off of the kills. But every time I pushed the wave, I took some plates, backed off, wave pushed back into me. It was optimal. The momentum backs were really effective at generating, utilizing gold, spending it, use the items, get bigger lead. A lot of people would try to overstay in their lane. They wouldn't use that gold, and they wouldn't be able to generate these big leads that carry games in 1v9. So hopefully you learned something. Hope you enjoyed. I'll see you next time.